And we are made to understand that addicts, they are not ashamed of what they like. In fact, they want everybody to know that they love this thing and nobody can stop them. Addicts are always found around their fellow addicts. There was one young man I met in Jos, a young boy, small boy. His wife left him because he was always drinking Brukutu. And the lady says she will not come back until he changed. So he was faking it that he has changed. Every time he will come, he will target when I'm driving around. He say, Pastor, that he has not eaten. I gave him the first time, gave him the second time, the third time. I say, come to church. So I now got one of my members. I say, give this man work. He says he's a driver. Give him work. So when they now told him that they are going to give him work, he ran away. You know, to collect the sweet. Eh? But to work the money. So when they now told him he should report, because he was in charge of Wando in Plateau, that they will give him work, either as a driver or as a pump attendant, he disappeared. So he now came back again and said, you are a thief. You are looking for free money. Now we want to give you work so that you will get the money. You are running away. So when he sees me, I'm coming, and that is Brukutu, he will just dodge. So me, I will intentionally stop. I say, I see you. He loves staying in the company of his addicts. So I now told my pastor that our evangelism will now be on all the Brukutu joints. So I was visiting all the Brukutu joints. And God helped me. I was able to catch some of them. We will attack this one this week. The next one will go to this one. And when they see me, say, Pastor, we are here. Hear me, that thing is a spirit. It's a spirit. You need power to break it. They were coming to church, but they were still going to the Brukutu joint. But we continued all the same. Little by little, they started disengaging, until they were established in the church. That will let you know how strong addiction is. I will let you know how strong addiction is. Anything that has power to disconnect you from serving God, it means that you are not serious. David said, my affection is set towards the house of my God. In this second service, we'll be focusing on the power of kingdom commitment. The power of kingdom commitment. Commitment is a state of being bound to a course of action. You are bound to a particular course. And you are giving it all it takes to make sure it works. Commitment is being sold out to a particular cause. Jesus said, for this cause was I born. Hear me? You are born for a cause. For a particular purpose. Commitment is an attitude that must be in place for success to be in view. Anything you want to succeed in, you must be committed in it. If you want to see success as a singer, you must give it commitment. If you want to see success as a footballer, you must train beyond normal training time. Whatever you are doing and you want to truly succeed in it, your commitment must be registered. You must give it all it takes. Why? Because you believe it will work. I've not seen one that is committed to a thing that he does not believe it will work. Until you are committed to a particular cause, you can never be accomplished in life. Meaning you can never be fulfilled. You can never see satisfaction. So it is one thing to be in a place. It's another thing for you to be occupied in that place. Jesus said, occupy till I come. I like to say this at this point. Places don't make people, but people make places. If you are in a place and the place is not filling you, you are not present. You are just counted among the number. Most people in life are committed because they want reward. But you can't truly be committed and be looking for reward. Reward naturally follows you. Reward naturally follows you. Reward naturally follows you. I remember I was in one particular station. Where, whether they like, they call it village church, or they let them not call it urban church. All I know that I was in a church. My colleagues told me that that place, in fact, they were feeling pity for me, but me, I was feeling pity for them. Do you know why? They felt they were in the city. While they thought I was in the village. But it was amazing that I was so blessed. To the point that people in the city were coming to ask me, how are you being blessed? So it's not location that determines your blessing. It is your commitment to what you are doing. When you are committed to what you are doing, whoever carries your blessing must locate you. Oh, you don't know? I'm the one telling you. Commitment does not just bring out the best of the work, it brings out the best you desire. The best you desire. A man's level of commitment in life to any particular cause will determine his attainment. Your commitment level will determine your attainment level. If you are not committed, you will not attain to anything. You may feel that you are marking time, but you don't know that you are wasting your life. This kingdom will not profit you beyond your commitment level. And funny enough, this kingdom is the custodian of everything that life has to offer you. So what you do to this kingdom will determine what it will release to you. And funny enough, God is the one holding the blessing that belongs to this kingdom. So your commitment level, whether pastor, whether choir, whether deaconess member serving in any unit, I tell you this and I lie not. Your commitment level will determine your change level. If you will change level in this kingdom, it will be determined by God. God looks at what you do to his house to determine what he will do to your life. So don't just sit down, feel comfortable. that I'm my own in second service. Let me tell you. Heaven only take record of your input, not the chair you occupy. Papa have always told us, God does not reward title or position. He only reward input. He only reward service. So if you are not committed to the advancement of this kingdom, you will not also be committed to the advancement of your life. No wonder we have many strugglers in church. Struggling as if Satan has given them a hunchback. Struggling as if God is behind their punishment. No. You determine what God will do in your life per time. You determine it. There are certain things I've been able to discover about commitment. You can't truly be committed to your cause or to your work and not end up being creative. Committed people are creative. Why? They are always thinking how best they will accomplish their assignment. So if you are truly committed, you will just suddenly discover you are creative. New ideas are just popping up. New ideas are just popping up. Why? You want to do it well. You want to improve on what you are doing. If you are not improving in what you are doing, then you are a failure. That's why every time I attack choir, I attack them very well. Do you know why I'm attacking them? At the time I just feel that they don't even know what they are doing. You can't be in this place and not think of improvement. The same way you were last year, that's how some of you are still are. Some people, when they see climb up, they are still missing key. Papa! As if they force you to come and sing. Do you know that if you mess up and leave now, there is somebody in congregation that will take your place? Do you know why you can't improve? No personal input. Anyone that is committed to improvement gives himself to personal development. If you are committed to improvement, you are bound to give yourself to personal development. When I was in choir, I don't do my rehearsal with instruments. I do my rehearsal with my head. I know 2 drum beats, 3 drum beats, 1 beat. But some, even with the instrument, with the keyboard, they will still be missing key. It's a sign that you are not committed to improvement. Anything you are doing and you are not improving, you are not committed. You too, you know you are not committed. Your commitment level affects your productivity level. Your commitment level affects your productivity level. Meaning, are you getting new results? Are you getting new results? Because anything you are improving in your commitment, the result level will begin to change. And truly, truly, if we are committed, all of us here, because scripture says, one shall chase 1,000. Two shall chase how many? Let me just say now that in this service, we are close to 1,004 or 1,005. Check where 1,000 person alone, let me not use 1,005, 1,000 person is committed to bringing one per Sunday. There won't be space here. How can you be committed to the advancement of the house and the growth of the house is not your concern? So when you are not committed to any particular area of the kingdom, you can never be creative in that area. Let's hear this again. Commitment is the backbone of any success. It's the backbone of any form of success. You can't be successful if you are not truly committed. What is the meaning of success? Having a good outcome. Having a favorable outcome. Having something coming out for you in a more better way. Successful. Did you succeed last year? God wants you to succeed much more this year. The path of the just is like a shining light. A shining brighter and brighter and brighter unto a perfect day. I want you to hear this. Prayer will not take the place of commitment. That's why commitment does not have substitute. You can be prophesied upon. If you are not committed, the prophecy won't work. They can pour you all the oil that we have available now. If you are not committed, you will still end up as a failure. The commitment we are talking about is the proving point of what you believe. Proving what you believe. You believe it, so you are committed to making sure that it enters your hand. This year, what eyes have not seen, what ears have not heard, shall be the order of the day in your life. You echo, amen. Now it is time to commit yourself to seeing what you have never seen before, to handling what you have never handled before. There is no substitute to commitment. Even though you have sown seed, you need to be committed for your seed to produce. The greatest undoing of many believers is coming to church and claim, I receive it. I receive it. I receive it. I receive it cannot take the place of commitment. Should I say this? If unbelievers are succeeding, it will be abomination for you not to end up as a success. If unbelievers are making progress, you must make progress. Do you know what? The devil cannot stop your reward when you are committed. Whether people gang up or arrange or pre-plan and say, let's not give him. Let's fight it and make sure it doesn't come to pass. I still have one understanding. Every good and perfect gift coming from above. You can stop what is in your hand, but you can't stop what is in the hand of God. Am I saying something to somebody? In fact, the one in your hand is even small compared to the one that is coming from the hand of God. So when you are committed, no man, say with me, no man, can stop what God wants to put in your life. No man. What you have is change. You don't have better money. The real thing is coming from God. No wonder the psalmist said, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. From where cometh my help? He said, my help coming from who? Every good and perfect gift coming from above. From the Father of light, in whom there is no variableness, neither any shadow of turning. Man can change his mind, but God can't change his mind. He said, by myself have I sworn, in blessing I will do what? Bless you. So be committed to the one whose word cannot fail. He said, faithful is he that calleth thee, who also will do it. When you are sure of where your reward is coming, men, you will not reduce your commitment. You will not reduce your commitment. Uncommitted people go from failure to failure. Committed people go from success to success. Uncommitted people go from hardship to hardship. Committed people go from pleasure to pleasure. What is commitment? Number one, commitment simply means readiness to pay the price. If I want to see prophecy fulfilled in my life this year, for my family, for this church, I have to pay a new price. I have to pay a new price. I have to pay my own price. What does it mean to be committed? To be committed also means to make available for use without reservation. God has given you grace, given you wisdom, given you talent, given you strength. Release it without reservation. Anything you know you have that will profit the kingdom, that will add value, that will increase glory, don't withhold it. Scripture says, withhold not good from whom it is due. When it is in thy power of thy hand to do what? Act. He said, do not say to your neighbor, go and come back tomorrow, when you have it right there with you. A committed man does not hold anything back that will move his work forward. Anything that will advance his life, he releases it. What does it mean to be committed? To be committed means to burn the bridges. You don't turn your back on God's cause. You are committed to the cause of God full scale. Say with me, full scale. My heart is here at full scale. Say with me, full scale. My heart is here full scale. I'm not envying any place because this is my right place now. This is my open heaven now. This is where I will enjoy the fullness of the backing of God now. So there's no need envying anybody. Maybe the person is in Abuja. They'll be the one to envy me. I'm telling you. Because where a man's heart is, that's where his treasures are. And you'll be committed to where your treasures, where your goods are coming from. Is this your father's house? I want to let you know, until you prove your commitment, you may delay his faithfulness. What does it mean to be committed? Commitment is the bakery for any man's greatness. Who has been to a bakery before where they bake bread? Commitment is the bakery place for great men, great women. Kenneth Hagin said, give your work all it takes so that it can give you all it contains. Give it all it takes so that it can deliver into your hand all it contains. I have proved God in other places. This one will not be a difference. I will give it all it takes so that he can give me all he has prepared for me. What eyes have not seen, what ears have not heard, shall be the order of the day in my life. So if that's what he's saying, I will give it all it takes so that great things will begin to answer for me. There is greatness in every one of you, but you need commitment to draw it out. If you refuse to be committed, great things won't answer to you. Great places won't call you. Great opportunities won't come your way. Do you know why you are meeting only small people? Do you know why you are meeting only foolish people? Because there is nothing in you that is calling for great people. See thou a man diligent in his business. He shall not stand before me, man. But before what? Prince and kings. So if you want to redefine the order, change your approach. Change your attitude. Change your style. The people that are coming to you now, you intentionally call them. But if you want to begin to meet great people, change your pattern. Change your attitude. Nobody will take you serious until you begin to act serious. Nobody will take you serious until you begin to behave serious. Papa said, until you begin to give the kingdom a serious approach, it will not give you a serious result. How you are treating this house, that's how God is responding to you. How you are treating his house, how you are treating this kingdom, that's how God is responding to you. We are very nonchalant, too lukewarm, over lazy. When it comes to church kingdom matters, praying for the growth of the church, reaching out to lost souls, is not their concern. Then you will want God to carry your matter on his head. Father Christmas. The Lord is with you while you are waiting. If you forsake him, he will also do what? Forsake you. Now, even in organizations, staffs that are not serious, they treat them like people that are not serious. Am I saying the truth? Staffs that are not serious, when they are discussing matters of relevance, they don't call them. Because he's not a serious person. So, if you put it in his hand, you are looking for trouble. Am I saying the truth? If you don't take his kingdom serious, why will he be committing serious things into your hand? Now, there are people seated here now, they are looking for serious money. Say the truth. Say the truth. You need serious money. Raise your hand. Hallelujah. But shall I shock you? For serious money to enter your hand, God will test your heart. Do you know how he will test your heart? If this money enter your hand now, what will you do to his house? When you are looking for serious money, how regular are you in paying your tithes? You won't raise hand again. Are you seeing it now? He that is faithful in little, much shall be committed to his hand. God tests us. Our commitment level is part of the test. You are moving, you are moving, you are moving, you are moving. Little by little, you are moving. He said, this one, if 10 million enter his hand, his heart no go shake. Angels, drop it, drop it, drop it. Move him to the realm of billions. Move him to the realm of billions. He has been found faithful in the realm of hundreds. Move him to that level. But God, can God say that about you? You see now, you are saying yes. When last did you pay your tithes? Are you seeing it now? You will be so surprised that God checks all these things. You'll be so surprised. Something shocked me some months back. I don't know whether it's just or David or Ebube. I gave him offering of 100 naira. I said, Daddy, you have passed this level now. I gave him offering, no, not that he's working. Are you seeing trouble? Now me give an offering. I said, Daddy, you have passed this level now. Change it. Do you know that I went back that night I was thinking, my son told me, I've passed this level, that his offering should have crossed 100 naira. I should make it up to the green one. My God. So, something down on me. I need to be more committed though. If they can say this, only God knows what God is saying. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? Do you know that that's how God is checking your heart? That's how God is checking your heart. Your commitment level determines your change of level. If you are not growing in commitment, how do you expect God to be changing your level? Do you know when it is time for reward if you are truly committed? Anywhere they lie, may they hide the paper, it must come out. Am I saying the truth? What are the characteristics of kingdom committed fellows? Number one, he walks with the end in view, just like Christ, for the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross. I want to let you know, there is nothing you are going through now that has the capacity to stop you from where God is taking you to. There is nothing. Is it financial challenge? It will soon expire. I say it will soon expire. Is it delay? Scripture says, surely there is an end. And thy expectation shall not what? Committed people, they walk with the end in view. Where I am now is temporal. I am gunning for my better place. I am heading for my better place. For the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross. In other words, you must be visionary in your approach. Hear me? You can pass without going to school, but you can't escape the realities of life. Am I saying the truth? You can pass without going to school. They can give you expo. But you cannot use expo to pass the realities of life. So when you are committed to a particular cause, you know where you are heading to. And hear me, not everyone will arrive at the same time. Because not everyone will give his commitment at the same pace. Anyone you see now fuel with energy, committed for the advancement of the kingdom, is because he has seen something. He has seen something which you have not seen. You may think he's a fool, over righteous, over spirit. It's what they do. Hear me? Bishop Abiyah said, those that take it too easy, they are eased out of life. You are taking this church thing too serious. Hear me? It is better you are too serious than that they say that you are too casual. Casual staffs, they are always the casualty. In any organization, when they make you a casual staff, pray that your name is removed. Because anything that happens, you must be a casualty. You must be among those that they will think of removing first to keep the real people. May you not end up as a casual staff. Amen. You better say a good amen. Amen. So if you know where you are going, you will not be bothered at where you are now. Where you are now is just a face. You enjoy its face per time. Be committed at that face. Why? Because you may not come back. Do you know that there are certain places and certain things you may not have a second chance to repeat? So you give it all it takes. So that when you move to your next level and someone is on that particular level, Say, how did you get to where you are? Man, where you find yourself now, man, give it all it takes. You may not know when God will come for you and change your level. Give it all it takes. Don't play casual. Give it all it takes. Don't play casual. Number two. What are the characteristics of kingdom committed people? They are goal driven and they are gain driven. They are goal driven and they are gain driven. They are driven by goals. They have set targets that must be accomplished. And they are gain driven. I've not seen any man anywhere committed him that commit himself in where he's not getting profit. Show me one. You are committed in what you are not getting profit is a lie. But God has already vowed and committed himself. You shall serve. I shall do what? That's an oath. He said, by myself have I sworn. In blessing, I will bless you. In multiplying, I will do what? Multiply you. My covenant will I not break. Psalm 89 and verse 34. My covenant will I not break, nor utter the word that have gone out of my mouth. You hear me? My commitment commits God. You have not heard this before. The moment I commit myself to the blessing of the people, I have committed God. Oh, you must bless me. I've committed myself to make sure that the service must be sweet. God, you have no choice than to make my life sweet. My commitment commits God. Why? He's under an oath, so I provoke the oath. So every time we are giving into a commitment, we are provoking the oath. You shall serve. I shall do what? So every time you are serving, you are provoking God. Lord, remember your word. Someone was given a sack letter. It happened to be this one that double period last year. Say, Lord, as I go out for this evangelism, let that letter be altered. He committed God. And the following week, they say, sorry, that letter was not for you. It was reversed. Another one said, Lord, as I go out for this evangelism, one soul, 1 million. I hope you know a soul is more costlier. So, when you are committed to kingdom advancement, seeing that souls are won, name your price. God can pay you. No wonder Papa said, serving God is the most profitable venture on planet Earth. He said, no oil company can pay me what God is paying me. And truly, truly, it works. Do you know why you are not committed? You don't believe the authenticity of his word. That's why you are gambling. If in case it doesn't work, so that I can have a space somewhere outside. Scripture says, he abided faithful. He cannot deny himself. So what is your goal for 2018? Towards the advancement of the house. What is your goal? What is your goal? If you are goal driven, you will just discover that grace is released upon you. Favor is released upon you. Why? The race is not to the swift. Not yet the battle to the strong. Not yet your favor to men of skill. It's a time and chance happening to them all. I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy, and I will show compassion on whom I will show compassion. So when your goal is towards the advancement of the house, man, the heavens opens up for you and releases everything that is needed for the accomplishment. Everything needed. So what I'm doing towards his house will determine what he will do towards my life and towards my family. Number three, characteristics of kingdom committed fellows. They rejoice at every challenge. Every challenge is a proving point for God to show up. They rejoice at every challenge. If challenges are not on ground, where will God prove his almightiness? So the more committed you are, the more God will show up on your matter. The more God will show up on your family issue. We recorded last week? One sister shared a testimony that a strong man that has been sitting on their family property surrendered by force. And another one just shared now. That's why I want to let you know, anyone that has vowed to sit on what belongs to you, fire go burn them. In case you forget anything, don't forget what I've just said. They will lose, their loins will be loose by force, and they will surrender what belongs to you and your family. If you are saying amen, say better amen. So no challenge is too difficult for God to handle for someone who has committed himself to the advancement of his house. No challenge. No challenge. Do you know why? My counsel shall stand, and I will do all of my good pleasure. So the more committed you are, the more you are provoking God. Lord, overturn this thing. Nothing is hard for you. Overturn this barrier. Overturn this challenge. And I'm glad to let you know, faithful is he that called thee, who also will do it. Faithful is he that called thee. He has not called you to use you and useless you. He has called you to improve you, to refine you, repackage you, bring you out in a more glorious form. Faithful is he that called thee, who also will do it. Lastly, characteristics of kingdom committed fellows, they hate comparison. They hate what? Committed people don't compare themselves with themselves. Now let me say this. If they refuse to do, look here. If they refuse to do, I will not allow their refusal to reduce my commitment. Because God will not rate me the way he's rating them. So if they don't commit themselves to the advancement of the work, they are not entitled to query. Because I'm not their paymaster. God is their paymaster. So if you are doing because somebody is doing, you are foolish. And funny enough, in church, some people, they reduce their commitment because somebody annoyed them. Bye bye. You are not in church because of God. You are in church because of the person. If somebody in church will reduce your commitment, you didn't come to serve God. You came to look at the person's face. If somebody says something about you, and because of that, you stop coming to church or you started hiding, you are only confirming that what they are saying is true. And funny enough, they spoke about Jesus. Who are you? They say concerning Jesus, he was filled with the spirit of Beelzebul, a demonic power. Why wouldn't they talk about you? Jesus even said, woe is you when men speak well of you. So I'm not expecting anybody here to speak well of me. Because you are not the one that is approving me.
You are not my paymaster. You are not my rewarder.
So what you say cannot reduce my commitment.
Even what they told you and you had believed
cannot reduce my commitment. That's the problem in church. Some people's commitments are reduced because, Pastor, I heard that they are talking about me. In fact, the more they are talking about you, the more you make shakara for them. I've said it anywhere I go. If what you heard about me is true, confront me. If not, you are a coward. You and the person that told you the thing, you are coward. You know who cowards are? Go and check the dictionary. If what they told you is true, come and collect Bishop Oyedepo's number or Bishop Abiodun's number and call it. Call them and tell them. If not, the person that told you and you that believe it, you are a mumu. That's why I'm not afraid anywhere I go. I do my thing with the whole of my heart. Anything you hear, now you, that one, now your own. Papa said something last week. Allow people that are talking about you to fulfill their assignments. They are fulfilling their ministry. You pursue your ministry. You know, recently now, there is one anointed fellow that is following one man called Sunday Adalaja that is abusing Papa. Papa said, even though they call me fake, allow them to fulfill their assignment. Me, I'm pursuing my assignment. Has what they said been able to stop where it's going? Why will you allow what people say reduce your commitment? It's a sign you don't know who you believe. Paul said, I know whom I have believed, and I'm fully persuaded. If you are committed, you will be fully persuaded. Committed people, they are fully, not partially, persuaded. Pursuing what they are pursuing. They don't compare. Because he said, let me reduce my commitment so that they will stop talking. Please, allow them to talk more. Tell your neighbor, allow them to talk more. Church is where people talk. And in Nigerian constitution, everybody is entitled to his opinion. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? Everybody is entitled to his opinion about you. So why are you breaking your head? Should that affect what God will do in your life? Let me summarize that point with this. If God were to be consulting people's opinion to determine when you will be blessed, I hope you know you are in trouble. If God were to be consulting people's opinion, he wants to bless Kelly now. He's now coming to ask Mike, ask Benga. All of them will have different opinion. Do you agree with me? But look at what he said. Every good and perfect gift from above, from the Father of light, in whom there is no variableness, neither any shadow of turning. Meaning, nobody can change God's mind when it is your turn to be blessed. So, if people's talk is making you reduce your commitment, you are a fool in this house. But from today, you cease to be a fool.
Anybody that wants to talk should talk. Allow them to talk. They are free to talk. But I've discovered that people that talk more about others, they are always afraid for their matter to come out.
Quote me, I said so.
That's why after telling you, they say,
don't tell him. Don't tell him.
Because they know if you tell him, matter go blow. But they don't want their matter to blow.
Please serve God. God loves you. Jesus said, I know there is one that speaks about me. And his testimony about me, they are right.
Don't expect everybody to speak well of you.
Do you like me? Do you like me? It's a lie. Everybody cannot like you.
Everybody can't like you. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? Huh?
So don't go and begin to compare. This one like me, this one didn't like me, so let me reduce. You are a liar. Your heart is not here. If your heart is here, you will not be interested in who like you. You will be focused and you will be desirous to please God. When pleasing God is your passion, what every other person is saying is immaterial. Now, which sin did Adeboye commit that small rat? We sit on Facebook and she'll be having followers. So, yes, tell them. They are already heading to hardship. So that Adeboye is using style to be collecting money from people. Adeboye or four people? She will think now that by saying those things that people will be hailing her. She will not know that hell has opened his mouth wide to swallow her. Please, I'm making all this reference to let you know that what people say does not have power to determine your commitments. Even people that are coming to watch, let me watch to know whether that thing they said is true. You are a fool. Do you know why you are a fool? It's because you don't have anything occupying you. You don't have any focus. You don't have focus. Because focus people have focus assignments. When people are now your assignment, it's a sign that you didn't have one before. So Satan has given you one. I'm provoking you from today. Never you compare yourself with others. If someone is making progress, get excited. Because very soon you will be making that same progress. If you are saying amen, say better amen. There is no height any man has attained that God cannot get you there. Scripture says, this same Lord is good unto all and bless all that calls upon his name. If someone has entered the realm of million, you are the next in line. I say you are the next in line. Don't sit down and begin to feel pity as if God has abandoned you is a lie. He that is faithful in little, much shall be added. Faithfulness is a proof of your commitment. And as you are going, that's how God will be changing your level. You will never be on the same spot again. If you are saying amen, say better amen. What are the rewards of commitment? Number one is honor. 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 You attract honor from God. You attract honor from men. You attract honor from God. What is the proof of honor? Blessing have entered. A new level of blessing have entered. It's a sign that God has honored you. Another reward of commitment is progress. Committed people are progressive people. Progressive. Progressive people. You can't be committed and be on the same spot. You are fulfilling scripture by being committed. Why? The path of the just is like a shining light that shineth brighter. Even the earth knows that this man cannot be on the same spot. So once you are committed, you will notice financial progress, material progress, career progress, family progress. You may be delayed, but you cannot be denied. And the last proof of reward of commitment is greatness. Greatness. The door of greatness only opens to committed people. Once you are committed to a particular thing now, the door is calling you. We have been waiting for you. It's people like you, people like you, people like you. We are waiting for you. Please, I want to let you know. Change your attitude towards the house. Be committed to this house. And I bet you, you can't be on the same spot. People that mocked you before, they will be among those to celebrate you. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. And now we are in the territory taking phase of the commission. Meaning God wants all of us, say with me, all of us, to be on the reach out for souls. You can't prove that you are committed to God and you are not committed to souls. What do I mean? You are not eager to see that someone is saved. You must be desirous to see that someone's life is rescued from the bondage of hell. Someone's life is redeemed from destruction. You must be passionate about it, so you must be committed to it.
In prayer, you are there. In reach out, in the evangelism and all the others, you are also there. You can't be doing this and God is saying, I'm not seeing. No, God will see it. God is watching. God is seeing. So this year, I want to let us know that what we have set as 10,000, God will give us more. You better say a good amen.
Amen.
And as you are committing yourself to it, that's how God will be increasing your favor level, your prosperity level, your progress level. Rise up to your feet. We are going to lift up our voice and pray. Lord, help me to be serious. Help me to be serious concerning your house. Help me to be committed. He said to the Galatian church, oh Galatians, who has bewitched you? Did you start in the spirit to end up in the flesh? Lord, help me to be more committed to the advancement of your house. Lift up your voice and pray that prayer. Lako Shantora de Zeni Galata. Lord, I need your help. Help to be more committed. Help to be more committed to the advancement of the church. Help to be more committed to the advancement of this house. Help to be more committed to the advancement of the kingdom of God. Help to be more committed to the enlargement of the house. Help to be more committed to the flourishing of the house of God. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for more help. I ask for your help. Your word said, day by day, you sent men to help David. Day by day, you are releasing help for him. Lord, release your marvelous help for me. In the name of Jesus Christ, I call for your marvelous help, Spirit of God. I call for your marvelous help, Spirit of God. Help me to be more committed. Help me to give in my best even this year for the enlargement, for the increase. To the increase, to the enlargement, to the flourishing of the house. Lord, I need your help. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are going to pray this prayer again. Every distraction that is reducing your commitment, Lord, by your fire, destroy that distraction. In the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever is reducing your commitment is a distraction. Lord, let your fire destroy every manipulation, every distraction the enemy has planted around my life. Whatever form of distraction the enemy has planted around me to reduce my commitment, to make me to be a slow mover, to make me to be on slow motion. Lord, destroy the bands of that manipulation, the bands of that distraction. In the name of Jesus Christ, lift up your voice, pray from the depth of your heart. Whatever power is distracting you, reducing your commitment. Whatever power is distracting me, reducing my commitment. Lord, by your fire, let it be burnt off. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we have prayed. All eyes closed, all heads bowed. You are here, you are not born again, but you want to rededicate your life back to God. You want to commit yourself afresh to God. Wherever you are, inside and outside, put your right hand on your chest and say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I come unto you today. I know that I'm a sinner. Forgive me. Wash me with your precious blood. I reject sin. I reject Satan. Come into my life. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. In Jesus' name I pray. If you pray that prayer with me, wherever you are seated, inside and outside, I'd like you to carry your bag and your Bible and come forward. Put those hands together for Jesus.
Behold the manner of love the Father has given.
If you are coming, come quickly. Put those hands together for Jesus.
Behold the manner of love the Father.
Just come. You don't need to be ashamed. Just come. Just come. God bless you. God bless you. Just come. You don't need to be ashamed. Put those hands together for the Lord.
Behold the manner of love the Father has given unto us.
If you are coming, come quickly.
Behold the manner of love the Father has given unto us. That we will be called the sons of God. That
they're joining them, join them quickly. Put those hands together for the Lord. This is the best decision any man can make. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus, unto them that come unto you, shall you in no wise cast out. They've accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and as their Savior, and they are standing, dedicating their hearts unto you afresh. Every guilt and every yoke of the past, by the blood of Jesus and by the anointing of the Holy Ghost, that yoke is destroyed now. As this oil come upon you, I decree your change of story starts now. In Jesus' name I pray. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. Whatever empowered the enemy to hold you in bondage before now, that yoke is destroyed permanently. Affliction will not rise the second time. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. From today, your life will experience the sweetness of God's blessing. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Put those hands together for the Lord. Pastor, see this one. Pastor, anoint your sister. Anoint your sister. God bless you. Just turn this way. Turn and follow this man right now. Turn and follow him. Jesus said, the zeal of my Father's house has consumed me. Everybody rise to your feet. Are you pregnant? Are you pregnant? Lord, as I partake of this communion, consume my heart with zeal for this house in the name of Jesus Christ. Lift up your voice and pray that prayer right now. Lord, restore my zeal. Let my heart be consumed with zeal for the house of God. Lift up your voice and pray. Let my heart be consumed with zeal in the name of Jesus. Let my heart be consumed with zeal. Zeal for the house of God. Zeal for the house of God. Lord, restore my zeal. Restore my passion. Restore my lost commitment. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, we thank you. And confirm your word in every life. In Jesus' mighty name.